Hi, welcome. This is Clemens the Elector. In this video, we will have a look at the MAX 78000 FTHR featherboard from Maxim Integrated, which is targeted at AI applications at the edge. At Elector, we bundled the board with the book How to Get Started with the MAX 78000 FTHR Development Board by Dogan Ibrahim in a convenient starter package. The MAX 78000 FTHR Feather is a small board based on the MAX 78000 microcontroller. This MCU is targeted at artificial intelligence or AI applications running at the edge. In this context, edge means there where it is needed, close to a sensor or a microphone or so, instead of somewhere far away in the cloud. The edge is, for instance, in your home or in your car or even something you wear. An AI application running at the edge does all the hard work by itself. To do so, it requires a good amount of processing power, and this is why the MAX 78000 combines an ARM Cortex-M4 processor with a floating point unit, a convolutional neural network accelerator, and a RISC-V core into a single device. Devices living at the edge are not supposed to consume a lot of energy, and so the MAX 78000 is also optimized for ultra-low power operation. Making AI inferences, that is answering questions like who is in the picture or what sound was that, is very energy efficient on the MAX 78000. A convolutional neural network, or CNN, is a special kind of neural network that uses convolution at its heart. Convolution is a mathematical operation often encountered in image and signal processing, and you can think of it as a kind of matched filtering. A CNN is a set of filters that scrutinize the input signal for certain features. CNNs are particularly useful in sound and image processing applications, and it is therefore not surprising that the MAX 78000 also integrates a camera interface and I2S for streaming audio. Its CNN is optimized for 1D signals like sound and 2D signals for image and video processing. Besides the already mentioned modules and peripherals, the MAX 78000 includes most common peripherals typically found in a microcontroller and some special functions related to IoT security, like a random number generator and an AES encryption engine. They are treated in depth in the book How to Get Started with the MAX 78000 Feather Development Board by Dogan Ibrahim. The MAX 78000 Feather is a small module. It measures only 66 by 23 millimeters. Featuring the MAX 78000, a tiny VGA camera, a digital microphone, stereo audio I/O, a micro SD card slot, 1 MB of QSPI RAM, an SWD debugger programmer port over USB, and a LiPo battery charger. There are also two user RGB LEDs and two user push buttons and extension connectors compatible with Adafruit's Feather form factor. A separate JTAG connector is available for programming and debugging the RISC-V core. The tiny camera on the MAX 78000 Feather may have some protective film on it. Make sure to remove it before trying out camera-based applications. When connected to a computer, the board is recognized as a composite USB device comprising a DAP link plus a CMSIS DAP web USB, a mass storage device and a serial port. The board comes preloaded with an audio keyword spotting demo. If you launch a serial terminal and connect it to the board's serial port, you will see instructions for using the demo. Out of the box, the demo recognizes the English words 0 to 9, go, stop, left, right, up, down, on and off. When it detects the word go, the demo enters number recognition mode in which it will blink an LED the number of times as commanded by the speaker. In other words, after saying 6, the LED will blink 6 times. Stop returns to normal mode. The serial monitor displays information about how confident the demo is about its performance. Nice as this may be, the keyword spotting demo does not toggle any pins on the extension connector or transmit data on another port than the USB port, and so you cannot control anything with it. A missed opportunity, if you ask me. To remedy this, or to create your own applications for the MAX 78000 Feather board, a development environment is required. For this, Maxim has prepared the Maxim Micros SDK that you can download for free from their website. The SDK contains the Eclipse IDE, MingW, GCC toolchains for ARM and RISC-V processors, OpenOCD and a few other utilities. The SDK also contains libraries, examples, and documentation. In short, it is all you need to get going on Windows. The procedure of how to install the SDK is described in detail in the book included in the bundle. Launch Eclipse Maxim SDK and select or define a workspace. Make sure there is no white space in the path. When the IDE opens, you will see a welcome screen that you can ignore and close. You can now either create a new project or import an existing one. From the File menu, click Import to import an example. Expand the first line in General and choose the wizard Existing Projects into Workspace. Browse to the project's root directory. For the SDK examples, this is Maxim SDK /example/max78000. We will import only the keyword spotting demo, so select the KWS20 demo folder. Also check Copy Project into Workspace, as we are going to modify the example, but we want to keep the original. After importing the example project, it must be configured for the Feather board, as the project defaults to the MAX78000 evaluation kit. Almost everything in the SDK defaults to the evaluation kit. To do so, edit the build command, accessible through the project's properties dialog in the section C/C++ build. Add board equals featherref A to the build command box and click the button Apply and Close. You may have to uncheck Use default build command first before you can do this. Open the file main.c and set sleep mode to 0. If you forget to do this, the board will no longer respond to the IDE as it is sleeping most of the time, and its wake-up periods are too short for the debugger to connect. To get out of this hole, you must execute the unlock a MAX78000 that can no longer be programmed procedure detailed at GitHub. The link is in the description below. Just to be sure, clean the project before continuing. Now click the Run button to see if the example compiles and works. You can do this with a serial terminal while talking to the board. 1 2 Go. I changed the keyword spotting demo so that it makes pin P.3 high when it hears the word on and clears the pin when it recognizes the word off. Depending on the keyword, the LED will either be green for on or red for off. If another keyword was recognized, the LED turns blue, but the pin doesn't change state. Pin P2.4 indicates confidence. When the confidence is too low, less than 95%, this pin goes low. Otherwise, it will go high. Also, if the keyword is a number from 0 to 9, pin P1.6 will pulse the given number of times. 1 is 1 pulse, 9 is 9, and 0 is 10 pulses. The pulse rate is 10 Hz. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 0 If the keyword is up, pin P1.6 will go low. When it is down, pin P1.6 goes high. Finally, I added UART2 to the mix. This serial port is available on the extension headers. TX is on pin P1.1 and RX on pin P1.0. And so it can be connected to another system that acts on the data received over this link. The recognized keyword and its confidence value are sent in JSON format. The baud rate is 115200. You can download my project from my GitHub repository, Clemens at Elector. The link is in the description below. With the modified keyword spotting demo presented in this video, the MAX78000 Feather board becomes a kind of a voice sensor that can control, for instance, relays or that can connect to another microcontroller. Now you can use it without having to dive into the super complex subject of AI training. This is a time and resource intensive task that must be done if you want the board to work with your own data. More information about how to do this can be found in the Maxim repositories at GitHub. I will not go into that. The book How to Get Started with the MAX78000 Feather Development Board describes the board and its peripherals in detail and has many programming examples in C. Unfortunately, the CNN Convolutional Neural Network Accelerator and AI training are only treated on an introductory level in the last chapter. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.